What if you could make an LED blink on and off all by itself, like magic? Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to build a super cool flashing LED circuit using just a few transistors. Stay tuned to the second part of this video, where I'll explain how this circuit works. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. Two jumper wires, a 1 kilo ohm resistor, a 1 mega ohm resistor, 122 ohm resistor, 1 2.2 microfarad capacitor, 1 LED, 1 BC557 transistor, 1 BC547 transistor, 1 9-volt battery, 1 9-volt battery buckle connector, a breadboard to connect everything together. A BC547 transistor is like a tiny electronic switch or a super small amplifier. Imagine you have a garden hose and you want to control the flow of water. A transistor works a bit like that. It has three legs or wires, the collector, the base, and the emitter. The BC547 is a special type of transistor called an NPN transistor, which means it allows electricity to flow in a specific direction. If you send a very small amount of electricity to the base leg, it opens the gate and allows a much larger amount of electricity to flow from the collector leg to the emitter leg. So a tiny push, small current, can control a much bigger flow, larger current. A BC557 transistor is similar to the BC547, but there is an important difference. The BC557 is a PNP transistor. If the BC547 is a switch that turns on when you push a button, the BC557 is like a switch that turns on when you release a button, or when there is a lack of a specific electrical signal. For a BC557, you need to reduce the electricity flowing to the base leg. When you do that, it opens the gate and allows a larger amount of electricity to flow from the emitter leg to the collector leg. Instead of needing a small push of electricity to the base like the BC547, the BC557 needs the base to be pulled down or have less electricity to let the main current flow. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the BC557 transistor on the breadboard. Insert it vertically so each leg is in a different row. Insert the BC547 transistor a few rows below the BC557. Just like the BC547, the BC557 should be placed upright with each leg in a separate row. Bend the ends of a 1000 ohm resistor. Insert the 1000 ohm resistor into the collector of the BC557 and the base of the BC547. Insert a 2.2 microfarad capacitor into the base of the BC557 and the collector of the BC547. The positive lead is in the BC557. Bend the ends of a 1 mega ohm resistor. Insert the 1 mega ohm resistor into the base of the BC557 and the negative rail. Insert a jumper wire into the emitter of the BC557 and the positive rail. Bend the ends of a 22 ohm resistor. Insert the 22 ohm resistor into the collector of the BC547 and the positive rail. Insert an LED into the emitter of the BC547 and the negative rail. The positive lead is connected to the emitter. Use a jumper wire to connect the LED to the negative rail. Connect the buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Insert the negative lead to the negative rail. Insert the positive lead to the positive rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This is a simple flashing LED circuit that uses two transistors to turn the LED on and off over and over again. The circuit uses a 9-volt battery to give it power. The main parts are two transistors, BC557 PNP and BC547 NPN, along with a few resistors, a capacitor, and of course, an LED. The 2.2 microfarad capacitor stores and releases electric energy, kind of like a sponge for electricity. When the circuit is powered on, the capacitor starts charging through the 1 megaohm resistor. When it fills up to a certain point, it sends a little electric signal to the BC547 transistor, which turns it on. When BC547 turns on, it lets current flow through the LED, and the LED lights up. The capacitor quickly discharges through the 22 ohm resistor and the BC557 transistor, which makes the LED turn off. If the LED isn't bright enough, you can use a lower value resistor to increase the current going to the LED. In this example, the 22 ohm resistor is replaced with a 10 ohm resistor. As more current flows through the circuit, the LED is brighter. Once the capacitor is empty, the process starts again, charging then discharging, over and over. This causes the LED to blink or flash on and off. The 1 kilo ohm resistor helps control the current going into the BC547 so it doesn't get damaged. All the resistors and transistors work together like a team to make sure the timing is just right. The capacitor fills and empties like a bucket, the transistors act like switches, and the LED blinks each time the circuit loops. I hope this video has shown you how to make a flashing LED with transistors. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.